Hello and welcome back again to MBAbullshitDotCom. So our topic for this video is the Economic Order Quantity Model, or EOQ. Remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Alright. Now this video talks about the basic EOQ model, or Economic Order Quantity Model. And after this, you can move on to my next video on MBAbullshit.com on EOQ with quantity discounts. Also, check out my other related free video on reorder point, or the basic ROP model. And after that, you can move on to my next video on MBAbullshit.com about reorder point with safety stock. So let's say, now let's start with a story, as I like to start with a story to make it easy to understand. Let's say that your friend Bob wants to buy basketballs from a factory and sell them to his neighborhood. Bob can buy the basketballs at $10 each from the factory, and he plans to sell it in his neighborhood shop for $20 each. He estimates he'll sell around 1,200 basketballs a year. Now at first, Bob thought of just buying around 100 basketballs per month from the factory, which will equal his 1,200 basketballs by the end of the year. However, Bob is kind of irritated at the factory because aside from the $10 cost of the basketball, the factory charges him a silly, crazy $90 ordering fee every time he makes an order. Maybe you've experienced this when you buy stuff from, say, discount airlines or whatever. They like to add on these crazy, silly fees to earn extra money. Well, anyway, so every time he makes an order, they charge him $90 ordering fee. Now, in MBA bullshit language, we call this ordering cost or setup cost. Okay, because sometimes it's not a fee for ordering, it's a fee to set up something. Because every time they service you, maybe they have to make to set up something new just to service you, to give you the service, and so they charge you a setup cost. So if Bob orders every month, then he'll have an added ordering fee cost of $90 a month or $1,080 a year. So Bob comes up with a clever plan. I'll just order all 1,200 basketballs only once for the whole year. So I'll just pay the $90 ordering fee one time. That's what Bob says. So he pays, or he decides to pay $90 a year in ordering fee instead of $1,080. But just when Bob thought he had the problem solved, he sees another problem. He doesn't have any space in his shop to keep many basketballs. Okay, he needs to rent extra space from his greedy rich neighbor who has a big garage. For any extra space, just enough to store one basketball, his neighbor charges $3 per year. So we'll call this holding cost per unit per year. Okay, so per unit, in this case we mean for each basketball, okay, because one basketball is one unit. So in other words, it's expensive for Bob if he orders few basketballs at a time because of the ordering fee or setup cost, which is $90 per order. And it's also expensive for Bob if he orders only a lot of basketballs at one time because of the storage rental fee or holding cost, which will cost him $3 per basketball per year, or $3 per unit per year. So what should Bob do now? Should he order a lot at one time, or should he order a little every month? Okay, what is the best number of basketballs that Bob should order at one time? Okay, so that number that we're looking for now is called the Economic Order Quantity, or EOQ. To find out the best or optimal number of basketballs, or EOQ, that Bob should order at one time, we use this super simple formula. The EOQ equals the square root. Now, so that this funny looking thing over here is called a square root. You can find it on your scientific calculator. The square root of 2 multiplied by 1,200 multiplied by $90 divided by 3. Now, where did we get these numbers? Over here. Okay? First of all, this square root over here is given as part of the formula. And this number 2 over here is also given as part of the formula. We did not get it from the story about Bob. Okay? Where did we get the 1,200, the 90, and the 3? It comes from the basic formula over here. 1,200 is the demand per year. So if you remember earlier in the story, it was given in the story that Bob expects to sell about 1,200 per year. So that's where we get it. Okay? Where did we get this $90? That is the setup cost, or letter S. Okay? Remember, every time Bob orders from the factory, that greedy factory charges him a silly fee, a silly crazy fee of $90 per order, or $90 ordering fee, or $90 in setup cost, which is over here. Where did we get this $3? That is the holding cost per unit. That's why we have letter H here. Remember, his greedy neighbor charges Bob $3 for every basketball per year that Bob stores it. So that is the holding fee per year for one unit of basketball. So that's here. Alright? So if we simplify that further, 2 multiplied by 1,200 multiplied by 90. Okay, so by the way, these letter X's over here, you see these letter X's? Those are multiplication signs, okay? Those are not variables. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 1,200 multiplied by 90 equals 216,000 divided by 3. We simplify that further. It looks like this. 216,000 divided by $3 equals 72,000. Okay? And then we get the square root of that. So how do you do that on your calculator? Well, that depends on your calculator, but on my own calculator, which is a Casio, you first press the square root number, and then you write the 72,000. So wait, let me try that just to be sure. Yep. So on my calculator, you first press the square root, and then you write, you input the number. Okay, make sure that you do this square root thing in the last part. Okay, you do not type the square root first and then do all these crazy computations. You only use this square root function on your calculator after you have only one figure left inside it, and you push the square root button and then input the number. So the square root of 72,000 is 268.33. So what do we learn from this? We learn that Bob should order 269 basketballs at a time, at each time. All right? So if Bob orders 269 basketballs at a time, he will have the lower cost, or lowest cost overall, instead of buying. For example, if he buys 250 basketballs at a time, his cost will go up. Why? Because it's less than 269. If Bob orders more than 269 basketballs at a time, if he buys 280 basketballs at a time, his cost will also go up. The optimal best number is 269. Now, you might wonder, why is this 269? We have the result of 268.33 because we always round it up to a nearer whole number. Well, actually, in this case, it's up to you if you want to round it off to 268 or 269. but you do not leave a decimal place in your actual number. Why don't you leave a decimal place? Because you cannot buy, okay, you cannot buy 0.33 of a basketball, right? Bob cannot tell the factory, hey, give me 268 basketballs and also give me 0.33 of one basketball. You cannot do that. So Bob should order 268 or 269 basketballs at each time. Now here's a tip, okay? At this number, 269 or 268, at this number, oh, by the way, do you round it off to the higher number, 269 or 268? My professor likes to round it off to the higher number, 269, but your professor might prefer 268. So check that out with him, which one he prefers. Okay? Now, here's a tip. At this number of 269 basketballs, okay, your setup or ordering fee per year will equal your holding and rental cost per year. So the total cost is more expensive when the setup cost and the holding cost is uneven, when they are not the same. So what we're actually doing with this formula is we're finding the number over here with which your setup cost per year or ordering fee per year will equal your holding and rental cost per year. All right. So that's how simple it is. You're now ready for my next video on MBAbullshit.com about EOQ or economic order quantity with quantity discounts. And you can also check out my other free video on reorder point or the basic reorder point model. And after that, you can move on to my next video on MBAbullshit.com about reorder point with safety stock. So there it is. Please, if you like this video, please share it. So on Twitter, we are at MBAbullshit. Look for us on Facebook, facebook.com/MBAbullshit, or forward my YouTube links on your email. Or simply post my videos on your Facebook. That'd be cool. Alright, so remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com for more free videos.